Hello friends, once again welcome to your favorite pharma channel Ram Pharma Academy. Pharmacy Council of India has published important advisory about academic examinations and progression of different pharmacy courses in India like D Pharmacy, B Pharmacy, M Pharmacy, Pharm D and B Pharm Practice. Here we are going to cover the recommendations for D Pharmacy and B Pharmacy. If you want to learn about recommendations for M Pharmacy, Pharm D and B Pharm Practice, then link is given in the description for the official document. Please go and read the document carefully. Students, currently whole world is under the threat of coronavirus affecting almost all the businesses around the world and hence declining the economy of almost all the countries including the developed nations. At the same time, this coronavirus problem is affecting the students directly or indirectly. And students are facing various problems during the learning process. So Pharmacy Council of India has given some advices or the guidance that we are going to discuss in this video. The guidances are divided into academic and assessment and progression and addresses all the programs approved by the Pharmacy Council of India under the Pharmacy Act 1948 and the various regulations and norms framed thereunder from time to time. These guidances are a one-time measure and shall be applicable only to the present academic year and will be reviewed or modified from time to time to remove difficulties, if any, file implementation. So Pharmacy Council of India has recommended some suggestions for the conduction of lectures or the conduction of the examinations. And this is going to be for only 1 year, this year, because this corona problem. For academics, the academic institutions through various orders of the government of India, state governments, statutory bodies and district administration have been asked to close completely or asked to suspend classes and offer teaching learning using technology and working from home. So currently we are also working from home and providing study materials to the students through the different social medias like WhatsApp, Facebook or on the YouTube. If you want to learn about different pharmacy topics, please subscribe to our channel to get the notifications. So similarly, several guidances have been given by the government of India and its autonomous bodies to use various learning resources, technology platforms and innovative teaching approaches. The students have been advised to study from home, maintain social distancing and restrict their movements from their present place of stay. Students, wherever you are, stay there and learn from home. This is the concept given by the most of the statutory bodies all over the world. Then the Pharmacy Council of India makes the following recommendations to the pharmacy institutions and pharmacy educators like us. The principals or the head of the institutions are advised to take necessary steps and put up the necessary timetable and structure in place so that the faculty are able to engage in online teaching to the students and complete the theory part of their curriculum through remote teaching for as long as the institutions have been asked to remain closed by the government and the district authorities in different parts of the country. Currently the lockdown is up to the 3 May, so colleges may not open up to 3 May. So students have to learn from their home. They may do so by sharing the learning resources in advance through their website, email to students and other learning apps, platforms that are available in this regard. The institution's faculty may document the details of the classes taken, the students engaged, the percentage of attendance and assessments and assignments conducted. So students, most of the faculty of your institutes are taking care of your education. So study from home, learn from home. About examination and progression, Pharmacy Council of India has recommended some suggestions like the institutions may conduct internal assessments in various courses as provided in the various regulations relating to the conduct of D Pharm, B Pharm, M Pharm, Pharm D, B Pharm practice program using online assessment mode like MCQs, open book test, assignments, problem-based assignments, etc. so that the students are able to complete a part of their academic requirement to be eligible for admission to the respective examinations. Means student has to learn all the topics during the curriculum. Like if you are in first year B pharmacy, you must learn all the subjects to appear for the examination. As regards to the university or board examinations, with reference to various pharmacy programs and the regulations and norms prescribed thereunder, the PCI makes the recommendations mentioned below for consideration and implementation. We are going to cover now the recommendations for the B pharmacy. Before moving to the recommendations for B pharmacy, if you are in first year and you want to appear for the second year examination, then you have to qualify or you have to appear for all the subjects in the previous year so that you can go for the next year examination. But now students can be promoted to the next year from these recommendations. The following recommendations are made in respect of examinations and progression to the next higher academic year. First point, the examining authority, if it finds appropriate, may consider that under the present circumstances, the students may not have had the opportunity to complete their academic coursework. In compliance with regulations, and the examining authority may not be in a position to conduct examinations in time for the student to progress into the next academic year or semester. Means students don't get the sufficient time to learn all the topics, or they are not able to complete the curriculum because of the COVID-19 problem. So examining authorities can consider the learning of students from online resources. Second point is, it is recommended that the students who have registered for a particular academic year or semester and have undergone the courses done and are not able to appear for the examination shall be permitted to progress into the next academic year or semester and shall be permitted to take the exams as may be planned by the examining authority during the ensuing next exams, or may conduct a special exam if they so desire. इसका मतलब है कि अगर आप फर्स्ट ईयर में है और आपको सेकंड ईयर में जाना है तो इस साल आपको शायद एग्जाम ना देना पड़े, पर ये रिकमेंडेशंस है. अगर ये रिकमेंडेशंस जो दिस रिकमेंडेशंस मस्ट बी रिव्यूड बाय द डिफरेंट एग्जामिनिंग अथॉरिटीज लाइक यूनिवर्सिटीज, एंड देन दे विल डिसाइड व्हेन टू कंडक्ट एग्जामिनेशन, हाउ टू कंडक्ट एग्जामिनेशन, व्हाट विल बी द पैटर्न और व्हाट विल बी द डिफिकल्टी ऑफ एग्जामिनेशंस. ऑल दोज थिंग्स विल बी डिसाइडेड बाय द एग्जामिनिंग अथॉरिटीज in the respective departments. Then third point is, the said candidate will also be eligible to take exams of semester or academic year that has been progressed along with the next academic year or semester, and shall be eligible to carry double the number of subjects to the next semester or year, that is 4 subjects. The power to suitably implement the same is delegated to the examining authority to decrease the degree of difficulty, if any, in this regard. Currently, we don't know how they are going to decrease the difficulty, whether it is in the form of difficulty level of the examinations or other things. And this is the authority is given to the examining authorities like universities. They have to decide how to conduct the examination. Then fourth point is, the student shall be eligible to secure class and distinction subject to their fulfilling the requirements mentioned in regulation 14 of the above regulations, and will not affect the same provided he passes in all the subjects in a single attempt. Means if you want to get the first class, you have to get more than 60% marks. If you want to get distinction, then you have to get the more than 75% marks as per the regulations given in the 14. But you have to pass in all the subjects in a single attempt. Then fifth point is, the examining authority may, as soon as possible, conduct the theory and practical examinations of the final year or final semester of the said program and announce the results in a time-bound manner so that students are able to pursue their higher studies or careers without disruption. However, the students will be considered to have pass the examination and be eligible for the award of degree only if they are successful in all the subjects of the said program. Means about the conduction of examination with next year or next semester examinations is for only for the first year, second year and third year. But about final year students, they have to appear for the examination as soon as the universities or the examining authorities declare the timetable for the examinations, so that they can follow, they can complete their curriculum in a time-bound manner. Then recommendations for the D Pharmacy. D Pharmacy is a 2-year course where Pharmacy Council of India has recommended some suggestions, like the examining authority, if it finds appropriate, may consider that under the present circumstances, the students may not have had opportunity to complete their academic course, working compliance with regulations, and the examining authority may not be in position to conduct the examinations in time for the students to progress into D Pharm Part 2. Means if you are in part 1 means the you are in first year D Pharmacy, and if you want to go to the D Pharm second year, you have to qualify, or you have to qualify the examination of D Pharm first year. But during this year, the recommendations given by the Pharmacy Council of India is, it is recommended that the students who have registered for part 1 and have undergone the courses done and are not able to appear for examination shall be permitted to progress into D Pharm part 2 and shall be permitted to take exams as may be planned by the examining authority during the ensuing next exams, or may conduct a special exams if they so desire. However, this shall not affect the progression of student to D Pharm part 2. Means agar aap D Pharmacy first year mein hai to aapko directly D Pharmacy second year mein bheja jayega, par aapko wo examination baad mein dene padenge. Aur about this examinations, the examining authority, like in Maharashtra, MSBT is the examining authority for the D Pharmacy course, which will decide about how to conduct examination and when to conduct examination for the D Pharmacy part 1. About part 2 examinations, the same that we'll discuss, the said candidate will also be eligible to take D Pharm part 1 exams along with D Pharm part 2. However, the students will consider to have passed the examination and be eligible for the award of diploma only if they are successful in both D Pharm part 1 and part 2. Matlab agar aapki D Pharmacy first year aur second year ki exam saath mein hoti hai to aapko dono bhi examinations mein pass hona chahiye, tabhi aapko diploma ki degree milegi. Otherwise you will be failed in the examination. Then this is for the first year students. The examining authority may as soon as possible conduct the theory and practical examinations of the D Pharm part 2 of the said program of the present academic years and announce the results in a time bound manner, so that students are able to pursue their higher studies or careers without disruption. However, the students will be considered to have passed the examination and be eligible for the award of diploma only if they are successful in all the subjects of the said program. Matlab agar first year mein hai to aapko second year mein directly bheja jayega, par uski examinations baad mein ho sakti hai, kab hone wali hai wo examining authority, like in Maharashtra MSBT, will decide about that. But about the second year D Pharmacy students, they have to appear for the theory and practical examinations whenever the timetable is declared by the examining authority. And if you pass in all the subjects, then you will get the degree or diploma. Then the student shall be eligible to secure class and distinction subject to their fulfilling the requirements as per regulation in 15 of the said regulations if they have passed their examinations in single attempt. Like in B Pharmacy, I have already told, if you get more than 60% marks, you are first class. If you are getting 75%, more than 75% marks, then you will be distinction. About D Pharmacy, you go through the regulations in 15, point number 15. Go through the document carefully. Then the sixth point is about the recommendations for D Pharmacy is, the students who have completed successfully their part 1 and part 2 and are required to undergo practical training as provided in Regulation 4 of the Chapter 1 of the regulations undergoing may be engaged using case-based studies, OSCE, through remote teaching, and where possible to be given credit to the number of days engaged such structured learning process where they have compiled with the provisions made in the Chapter 3 of the Education Regulation in 1991. So pharmacy comes, for the deep pharmacy, you have to go through the training program, and this training program can be gone through by the recommendations given by the Pharmacy Council of India, like undergoing, maybe engaged using case-based studies or OSCE through remote teaching, means at distance learning, like you can complete your training program. So these are the recommendations provided by the Pharmacy Council of India for the D pharmacy, B pharmacy, then about M pharmacy, Pharm D and B Pharm practice. If you want to learn all those recommendations, go through the document carefully. Link is given in the description for the official document. Students, these are only the recommendations given by the Pharmacy Council of India to the examining authority or the institutions. But now it's duty, or it is the time of decision from the examining authority when to conduct examination and how to conduct the examinations. So share this video with all your friends, and thanks for watching the video. Please subscribe to our channel. Goodbye. Take care.